Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to our 15th lesson of our Simplified Tajweed series, which is a series of Tajweed lessons introduced by Quran University uniquely designed Quran learning management system with the purpose of introducing Tajweed in a modern and easy approach. Through this series of lessons, you'll be introduced to Tajweed rules using a unique, modern, and innovative approach to teach Tajweed, utilizing the color codes of Mushaf Tajweed as a common denominator to link between those lessons and Tajweed rules. With such approach, we aim to make the understanding of Tajweed rules much easier and help you to practically apply those rules while reading the Quran. So let's start Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim with our topic for this lesson, which is an introduction to Mim Sakina rules, during which we're going to elaborate on the idgham and idhar of the Mim Sakina. If you remember what we have discussed in the previous lesson, where we have introduced the concept of two letters convergence. In this lesson, we'll show you that the Mim Sakina, the still Mim, is actually no more than a special case of the two letters convergence. In this introduction on Mim Sakina rules, we prepare you for the following lesson on Ikhfa of Mim Sakina. Let's revise what we have learned in the previous lesson, where we have mentioned that we have four possibilities for the convergence of any two letters, which can be either identical, similar, close, or distant letters. And we defined each one of those and the difference between them. Then we talked about the probabilities of vowelization versus still status of those two letters. And those four probabilities would be based on the first and second letter haraka and sukun, where the first probability was having the first letter being still and the second letter being vowelized. And then we mentioned that the associated tajweed rules will be based on this order. So with this first situation, there was idgham and idhar. And then there were the other three other possibilities or probabilities with the tajweed rules associated with them. We'll realize that the rules of Mim Sakina is a special case of two converging letters. The first one is a still Mim followed by a vowelized letter, whatever it is. The two converging letters will be identical if we have a Mim and Mim. And if we want to take an example of the similar letters, we have the Mim and Ba. They are similar because they both articulate at the lips. They are both labial letters. An example of closed letters is Mim and Noon, since both shares the characteristic of ghunnah, nasalization, while an example of distant letters is Mim and Ain, since they neither shares the articulation point nor any of their characteristics. Let's look at this example. وَجَاءَهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُوَعَدُونَ Mim, Sakina, has met with a Mim متحركة, identical letters. First is still, second is vowelized. Mim Sakina met Mim Mutaharrika. We realize that the convergence of Mim Sakina with the following letter always comes in two words. Let's take an example. وَجَاءَهُمْ If we look at the first word, end of it has a Mim Sakina. مَا يُعَدُونَ Second word has a Mim with Fatha, Mutaharrika. This conversion, the convergence of the two Mims happens in two words. First silent with sukun, while the second one has haraka. So still Mim, Mim Sakina at the end of one word has met a following letter of the beginning of the following word. Similarly, fahkum, look at the Mim Sakina here, baynahum. We realize that the still Mim, the Mim Sakina, at the end of the first word had met with the ba mutaharrika at the beginning of the following word. As a conclusion, we realize that Mim Sakina comes always in two words, unlike the Noon Sakina. The Noon Sakina had two possibilities, where it might come in two words like the Mim Sakina, but in addition to that, it has the possibility of coming in a single word, contrary to the Mim Sakina, which comes always in two words. With that background, we can now understand the Tajweed rules of the Mim Sakina, of the still Mim. The first rule is idgham, merger, of the Mim Sakina. جاءهم, Mim Sakina, followed by another Mim, Ma, in a second word. جاءهم ما. We actually merge these two Mims together. We merge the first Mim into the second Mim to produce a Mim with Shadda. جاءهم ما. جاءهم ما. Look at the Quran. ثم جاءهم ما. Mim Sakina with Mim following it. And we'll notice that we don't show the sukun here on the first meme, but a shadda on the second meme, which is now appearing in green, indicating idgham with ghunna. Still meme plus vowelized meme, meme with fatha, results in idgham, which is given the color green. It happens only with meme. So idgham only happens with meme, two identical letters. First meme with sukun, followed by a meme which is vowelized. So idgham or merger of meme sakina is actually an idgham of identical letters given ghunna. Now we'll move to the next hukum, which is ikhfa or masking, ikhfa of meme sakina. Fahkum baynahum. In this case, we have a meme sakina followed by a letter ba, which is vowelized. It has a fatha. Fahkum baynahum. What we do is we make ikhfa for the meme, masking the meme sakina, eliminating the oral articulation of the meme, yet preserving its nasal articulation. فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ Meme still, sakina, with ba vowelized, gives us labial ikhfa. And we call this ikhfa labial or labial masking in order to differentiate it from the ikhfa of the noon. Since the meme is a labial letter in its articulation, while the noon is an oral lingual letter in its articulation. So whenever we hear labial ikhfa, we know it's related to the meme. Now we're going to discuss the second rule for meme sakina, which is idhar, exposure. And the same thing we've said in our lesson related to the noon sakina about its idhar, about its exposure, applies here, where we said that idhar means exposing the pronunciation of the letter clearly without any modification, neither applying idgham, nor ikhfa, nor iqlab, nor any other modification of the letter, where the letter is pronounced as it appears. Now, let's take an example that explains why exposure is needed. Lahum fiha, mimun sakina, followed by a letter with haraka. Now, lahum fiha, if we try, for example, to merge the meme into the fa, it would result in a very funny word like this, lahu fiha, then such merger is not proper. The meaning and the word has changed totally. That's why such merger is not allowed. We have to clearly expose the pronunciation of the meme and the fa, where both letters has to be exposed. They have to be pronounced as clear as they are written. That's why idhar is necessary whenever a letter fa follows a meme sakina. Idhar is the rule, unless otherwise indicated, in which in Mushaf al-Tajweed would be given no special colors, because whatever you see in black should be pronounced clearly. Lahum fiha. Lahum fiha. Color black is given for idhar letters. So still meme with a vowelized fa leads to labial idhar, labial exposure. And as we said, it's labial because it's related to the meme to differentiate it from the idhar of the noon sakina, because noon sakina is a lingual letter while the meme is a labial letter. So idhar, as we said, is the rule unless otherwise indicated. So idhar is always the rule with any letter that follows the meme sakina, with the exception of only two letters, the meme and ba, where the rules are idgham with ghunna for the meme and ikhfa for the ba. With that, we can summarize the rules of the meme sakina, that the meme sakina has three possible tajweed rules arising whenever it converges with another letter of the alphabet. The three rules are ikhfa, and we call it ikhfa on shafawi, labial ikhfa, and idgham, merger, and idhar, labial idhar, exposure, labial exposure. So, labial, masking, merger, labial exposure, ikhfa shafawi, idgham, idhar on shafawi. Now, the rules, whether ikhfa or idgham or idhar, are based on the letter that follows the meme sakina. So ikhfa comes when the following letter is a ba, and it's only the letter ba that causes ikhfa of the meme sakina. idgham comes with only one letter, which is the meem, and that idgham is an idgham with ghunnah. So one letter causes the idgham of ghunnah of the meem sakina, which is the letter meem. While idhar is caused by all the other letters of the alphabet except the meem and ba. Let's now take some examples on the idgham with ghunnah for the meem sakina. And we'll start with the first example. في قلوبهم مرض. We find there is a meem sakina here, followed by a meem with haraka. In this case, it's a fatha. So the still meem, the meem sakina, was followed by a vowelized meem, meem with haraka, in two words. The first meem in the first word, the second meem in the second word. قلوبهم مرض. What we do is we take the sukun out, keep the meem without sukun, and merge the two memes together, producing a meme with shadda. Merge the still meme, the first meme, into the second meme, producing a meme with shadda. And since it is now stressed, the meme is stressed because we've merged the two memes together, we augment the ghunnah, since the ghunnah of the first meme will be added to the ghunnah of the second meme, producing a significant ghunnah. That's why we give it the color green. قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. We realize that the ghunnah has been exaggerated due to the merger of the two memes together, and that's reflected by a shadda on the second meme and giving the second meme the color green. So it's dram with ghunnah. Now we'll take the second example. خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا لَكُمْ مَا. First meme in the first word, sakina, as we see. Second meme in the second word, again with a vowel. In this case, it's a fatha. And the two memes now, the hukum is to bring them together. Lakum ma. So what we do, we merge them, producing a shadda on the second meme and adding the two ghunnas together and reflected by the color green. So we merge the still meme, first meme, into the second meme, producing a shadda on the second meme, given the color green, indicating ghunnah. لَكُمْ مَا لَكُمْ مَا لَكُمْ مَا. Third example. أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ. أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِمْ سَاكِنَة in the first word, followed by مِنْ meme with كَسْرَة in the second word. So the still meme, the sakina meme, followed by a vowelized meme with kasra in two words. The hukum, at'amahum min. We're going to remove the sukun from the first meme, and we're going to add a shadda for the second meme, because we merge the two memes together, and reflect that with the shadda with kasra on the second word, and give it ghunnah, because we're going to merge the two ghunnahs into one ghunnah. So merging the still meme, the first meme sakina, into the second meme, producing a shadda and ghunnah reflected by the color green. أطعمهم من أطعمهم من أطعمهم من. And with this we conclude our examples on idgham with ghunnah. And we'll move now to the examples on idhar, on exposure of the meem sakina. We're going to take the first example. لهم جنات. Meem sakina followed by a letter other than a meme and other than a ba. In this case, the still meme followed by a vowelized letter in two words other than the meme and ba. In this case, it's the jim. The jim has a fatha, vowelized, and it's not meme, it's not ba. Then the hukum would be idhar. Lahum jannat. Both the meme with sukun and the jim with fatha would be exposed, clearly pronounced without any alteration. No ikhfa, no idgham, no iqlab. They will be always clearly pronounced as they are written. And that's basically what idhar is. So what we'll do, both letters should be pronounced clearly, and that is basically idhar, which means exposure. And that's why it's given the normal color of writing, which is black. Second example, fi amwalihim haqqun. Meem sakina followed by another letter, the ha. So the still meem, the sakina meem, followed by a vowelized letter other than the meem and ba. Ha is not a meem, not a ba. In that case, we're going to have إظهار حكم أموالهم حق أموالهم حق and both letters should be pronounced clearly, which is basically إظهار and given the color black. Third example, وأنتم داخرون. We'll find that the ميم of the first word, ميم ساكنة, followed by a dal, a vowelized letter with فتحة, and that letter is not a ميم and با, so it's a dal. In that case, the حكم is إظهار for both letters. أنتم داخرون. Both letters should be pronounced clearly, and that's basically إظهار or exposure, and it's given the color black. أنتم داخرون. أنتم داخرون. Both letters are pronounced clear. Now we're going to apply what we have learned in a practical sense. In this ayah, the Quran, the shaded ayah, we are going to extract idgham with ghunna for nun sakina. So let's look for a meme that has been given the color green indicating ghunna, and that is basically the second meme in idgham with ghunna of the meme sakina. And let's see here. This meme sakina followed by a meme that has been given the color green, and the hukum here, at'amahum min. At'amahum min. We're going to merge the first meme sakina with the second meme, producing a shadda and a color green indicating the ghunna. At'amahum min. Another example. He's here. Amanahum min. Meme sakina followed by a meme with kasra, converting the second meme to produce shadda, and both are merged together, producing an exaggerated ghunna. Amanahum min. And now let's look at these two ayahs and try to extract idhar for nun sakina from them. And remember that idhar is given the black color. The exposed still mean with idhar and the following letter would both be given the color black. So let's see here. Lam yalid. Lam yalid. Both the meme and the ya are given the color black, and both are pronounced clear. Lam yalid. Next example is لم يولد. لم يولد. Again, the meme with sukun and the ya with dhamma, both are pronounced with idhar clearly. لم يولد. One more example. ولم يكن. لم with sukun and the ya with fatha, both are pronounced clearly. لم يكن with إظهار. Now we're going to summarize the whole lesson in one slide. In this lesson, we realize that the ميم ساكنة is a special case of conversions of the two letters. We have also introduced the تجويد rules for ميم ساكنة and then elaborated on the إدغام and إظهار of the ميم ساكنة. The إدغام, we took the situation where إدغام is to be applied. It is when the ميم ساكنة meets another vowelized ميم. And in that case, it's only the letter ميم. The rule, merge the still meme, the first meme, sakina, with the second meme, the meme mutaharrika, producing a shadda and maintaining ghunna for 2 units. The example, في قلوبهم مرض, meme sakina followed by meme with fatha, both of them produce a meme with shadda. قلوبهم مرض. Another example would be خلق لكم ما. Then we took the idhar, where we explained that the idhar happens when the meme sakina meets any letter other than the meme and the ba. So the letters for idhar are all letters apart from meme and ba. The rule, keep both the meme sakina and the following letter fully exposed, which means pronounced clearly without any modification. And we took examples such as lahum جنات and أموالهم حق في أموالهم حق. With this, we reach the conclusion of this introduction on the ميم ساكنة rules, in which we have elaborated a bit on the rules of إدغام بغنة and إظهار of the ميم ساكنة, while the إخفاء of the نون ساكنة will have a full lesson dedicated for it, which is the following lesson. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that بعونه وقدرته, that the Quran learning management system, برنامج الجامعة لحفظة كتاب الله, would help you, inshallah, to improve your tajweed and improve your tilawah and help you in improving your recitation and help you, if you want, in memorizing the Quran and to help you understand the Quran in the proper way. As we reach the end, we ask Al-Mawla Azza wa Jal أن يتقبل منا هذا العمل. We ask Allah Almighty to accept this work from us. And we ask you to make dua for those who participated in making this work come to life and reach you. Hoping you all the best. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.